So good afternoon class. Today we have to start our chapter number 3, that is periodic classification of elements. Okay, so I'm going to share my screen with you and let's begin our today's class. So beta, tell me, I think you have learned about the periodic table in 9th class. My screen is visible to you?
Yes ma'am.
Yes ma'am.
Yes, so I think you have learned about the periodic table, the elements in 9th class and as well as in 10th. And I think in 8th class we have chapters metals and non-metals, right? So in 8th class, in 9th class, we have learned that the elements are divided into two categories. Okay, so what was that category? First is metals, second one is non-metals. So in the beginning, when the scientists start, like they just start segregating the elements which are present in the earth crust or which are present in the nature, so they just divided all the elements into two categories. First is metals and second one is non-metals, right? But after that, when they start performing some experiment on these elements, they came to know that there are some elements which have properties of metals and non-metals, both. What is the name of these elements which have properties of metals and non-metals?
Metalloids.
Metalloids.
Perfect. So, in 10th class, we came to know that we have three types of elements. First, metals, second, non-metals, and third one are metalloids. They shows the properties like physical and chemical properties of both metals and non-metals. What are physical properties? Physical properties are like which we can see, which we can feel, like smell, the color, the structure, the shape, right? These are physical properties. And chemical properties are like when we do some chemical reactions or when we perform some experiments in the lab, at that time, the reactions, the like the things which are shown by an element are known as chemical properties. For example, if we compare water and HCl, the physical properties are nearly same. Both are liquid, both are transparent, meaning okay, opaque, right? But if we smell, so we can identify that we have a pungent smell in HCl and we have no smell in water. On the basis of physical property, we can identify. But if I want you to identify, you have to discriminate both these things on the basis of chemical properties, then what you will do? How you can discriminate between these two elements, these two compounds on the basis of chemical properties, then what will you do to find out the thing? Can any one of you tell me?
Ma'am, we can make them react with the metal carbonates.
Yeah, we can make them react with something else. For example, if you put a pinch of salt, then what will happen if you put the salt or what? Or just we take example, simple water. If we put some drop of water directly into the acid, then what will happen? Some reaction will take place. We will see some effervescence, like we will see some vaporization in that. But if we add the water drops in water only, then we will not see any reaction. So at that time, the reaction which led to the evolution of vapors or gases, that is the chemical. Okay, so now when the like in the scientists keep on trying, like experimenting on these elements, they every time, each and every time, they find out that there is a difference in each and every element, each and every matter which is present on earth. Somehow they are different in physical properties and some difference in physical properties and chemical properties. So in this lesson, we shall study about like the earlier attempts which were made by the scientists for the classification of these elements. Okay. I think we have seen a periodic table. आप लोगों ने periodic table देखा होगा. हमेशा उसमें एक chart बना होता है, elements लगे होते हैं. That is the modern periodic table we have. But before this modern periodic table, we have so many tables which led to the formation of the final table. So we will, in this chapter, we will learn all the attempts which were made by the scientists to finalize the final table, to discriminate, to describe the elements on the basis of the properties which they have. Okay, so first, the earlier two attempts were made on the basis of which all the elements are grouped into two classes, that is metals and non-metals. But there is a difference. I think this thing I have already told you, there is a difference in both metals and non-metals, because some of the elements are there which have properties of both elements. Okay, so we don't have any class, we don't have any place to put these elements where we can put it. Okay, so after this, scientists made attempts to recognize some pattern or regularity in variation of the properties of elements. So first point was that the scientists took the property of element as the main point to discriminate between the elements. उन्होंने सबसे पहले किसको लिया? Properties of elements को agenda बनाया कि भाई जब properties में difference है तो क्यों ना इनको हम इनकी properties के basis पे अलग करें. Right, so first scientist, the first attempt was made by Daubernier. Daubernier was the scientist, he was a German scientist. He just tried a new thing. He made some groups of three elements, and these are known as triads. That is the name of group of three elements which have similar properties. Okay, for example, lithium, sodium and potassium, all three are metal. All three shows metallic properties. So he took lithium, sodium and potassium because they show the same property as metal shows, right? So this group is known as triads. So all three elements of this triads is in their similar properties. So he observed that the atomic mass of the middle element of the triad is nearly equal to the arithmetic mean of the two elements. What does it he means? He stated that, for example, these three elements are there. Okay, so first is lithium and third one is potassium. If you find out the arithmetic mean of the atomic masses of these two elements, after that you will find out the atomic mass of the middle one, like here. Mean of the atomic masses of lithium and the third element, that is potassium, is 23. So the atomic mass of the sodium is 23. That was his concern. Us time ke liye this was actually a successful thing, because jab bhi wo three elements ko lete, he came to find out the atomic mass of the middle one. Okay, as you can see in this also, calcium, strontium and barium, 40, 130 plus divided by 2, arithmetic mean is 88.5 U. So 88 is the atomic mass of this. So as we can see in this also, chlorine, bromine and iodine, 35.5 plus 127 divided by 2, that is 81.5, which is nearly equal to the atomic mass of this 80. Okay, so he find out that in a triad the atomic mass, the sum of the atomic arithmetic mean of first and third element is equal to the atomic mass of the middle element. Okay, so at that time this theory was successful, nearly successful, but he did not receive a wide expectation. Like nobody accept this thing ke every time this formula will not work. So that is why his theory was discarded. After that, Newland, he came over and he explained about the law of octaves. Octave means, as he took the like triads, and Newland come and he proposed the law of octaves. Unhone three ka pair liya tha and he took the pair of eight, means eight elements. It's like sa re ga ma pa. I think you are familiar with the dhun sa re ga ma pa dha ni. We have seven. हमारे पास जो स्वर्ण उसमें होते हैं ना, वर्ण माला, जो क्या चीज बोलते हैं इसको, इसमें म्यूजिक, उसमें हमारे पास सेवन है, तो जो एट आएगा वो एस आएगा, राइट, वापस से वो सा आ जाएगा. तो उन्होंने ये बोला कि लाइक अ म्यूजिकल थीम, जिस तरीके से हमारे पास हमारी म्यूजिकल थीम में सेवन, हर सेवन के बाद एट्थ जो होता है वो फर्स्ट के इक्वल है. सा रे गा मा पा धा नी सा, सा सा इज इक्वल. सो ही स्टेटेड दैट दिस कैन बी फॉलोड इन the classification of the elements. That is why he named his law as the law of octaves. Okay, so he stated that when elements are arranged in the increasing order of their atomic masses, every eighth element had the properties similar to the first element, right? So he arranged the element on the basis of their atomic masses. Okay, so that is why he gave the new name to his law, that is law of octave. It was due to its similarity with musical notes, that is sa re ga ma pa. This is the different type of like musical notes which he used to use, because every country has its different types of musical notes. So in Hindi we used to say sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa. So in after seven notes, our same type of means a repetition of note is there. The first will repeat itself in the eighth one. Okay, so this thing can be explained like this. For example, he arranged the elements in the form of a pattern, in a like musical note pattern. Lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine. He arranged the elements on the basis of their atomic masses. After that, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, argon, potassium, gas. Argon is not there, okay, because that is inert gas. So first lithium, second beryllium, third boron, fourth carbon, fifth nitrogen, sixth oxygen, seven is fluorine. After then, when he came back to the sodium, since sodium is metal, lithium is metal, and below this we have potassium. So on the basis of this, he can explain that the elements, the first element and the eighth element, will show the similar properties because they are metals. They have physical and chemical properties nearly similar. They react with the compounds in a similar way. So that was his perspective. So what Newland stated, he arranged the elements on the basis of the increasing order of their atomic mass. Secondly, he stated that the property of first element will be similar to the properties of the eighth one. Okay, so with the help of arrangement given below, you can state that lithium is quite similar to the sodium on the basis of properties. So he stated that the properties of the three elements which are similar, like lithium, sodium and potassium, shows the similar properties. On the basis of this, he arrange the elements. But this theory was not accepted by the Mendeley. He worked on his periodic law and gave a new periodic law, that is Mendeleev periodic law. He was a Russian chemist. He, while trying to classify the elements, discovered that on arranging the increasing order of the atomic mass, element with similar chemical properties occurred periodically. He took that concept of Newland, that if we arrange the elements according to the increasing order of their atomic masses, then elements with similar chemical properties occurred periodically. वो हर बीच बीच में जिन जिन की properties similar थी वो एक periodic way में arrange हुई, right, chemical properties ke basis. Then he started his observation and proposed Mendeleev periodic law. So now we will learn about this, the Mendeleev periodic law. So in this periodic law, he framed a tabulation. He framed an arrangement. In this, the elements are arranged on the basis of their physical and chemical properties, physical and chemical properties with the function of their atomic masses. So he took the he related the physical and chemical property with the atomic mass. Jo concept hamara Newland ne liya tha atomic mass wala, unhone yehi bola ki bhai hamari physical properties are wo match ho rahi hai. Newland ne ye concept liya, but Mendeleev ne bola physical ke sath sath hamari chemical properties bhi similar hoti jati hain. Right? कि भाई हमारा लिथियम और सोडियम को अगर हम रिएक्ट कराएंगे, इट विल रिएक्ट लाइक सेम, दोनों एक तरीके से ही रिएक्ट करेंगे, सिंस दे बोथ आर मेटल्स, दे विल डोनेट द इलेक्ट्रॉन, दे विल शो नियरली सिमिलर, लाइक दे कैन फॉर्म ऑक्साइड व्हेन रिएक्ट विद ऑक्सीजन, दे कैन रिएक्ट विद एसिड, दे कैन रिएक्ट विद नाइस. ही एक्सप्लेन the physical and chemical properties, and they relate these things to atomic mass. So what was that? The chemical and physical properties of the elements are a periodic function of their atomic masses. हमारी जितनी भी फिजिकल एंड केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज हैं एलिमेंट्स की, वो किसके वजह से हैं? उनके एटॉमिक मासेस की वजह से हैं। ये मेंडेलीव ने आके कंसेप्ट दिया, राइट? सो अ पीरियडिक फंक्शन इज द वन व्हिच रिपीट इटसेल्फ आफ्टर अ सर्टेन इंटरवल। सो व्हाट पीरियडिक फंक्शन मीन? पीरियडिक फंक्शन मीन्स दैट व्हिच रिपीट आफ्टर व्हिच रिपीट इटसेल्फ आफ्टर अ सर्टेन इंटरवल। As Newland said, he stated that the first element will be similar to the eighth element, right? So that is the periodic function. He stated that the periodic function is when something repeat after it itself after an interval of time. So thus, according to the periodic law, chemical and physical properties of the element repeat themselves after a certain interval of time when they are arranged in the increasing order of their atomic mass. What it? When we arrange the elements on the basis of their atomic masses, then we will see the physical and chemical properties will repeat itself after an interval of time. As the physical and chemical properties of lithium and sodium are nearly equal. Means if it is repeating itself after the seven elements. Okay? Is this clear to you all, beta? Yes, is this clear to you all? Okay. So the tabular.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So a tabular arrangement of the elements based on the periodic law is known as periodic table. Now we came to know a specific name which is given to the arrangement of the element, right? So that arrangement is known as periodic table. So Mendeleev believed that the atomic mass of the element was the most fundamental property and arranged them in an increasing order in a horizontal law till he encountered an element which has properties similar to the first. Now he believes that the atomic mass of the most fundamental properties which are arranged, he is arranging the elements on the basis of the atomic masses in a horizontal way. Horizontal means they are arranging it in horizontal, like parallel to the surface. Okay, he at this time was not talking about the vertical lines which are known as groups. Okay, so he stated that if we arrange these things in a horizontal row, then what is the reason? So kab tak usko arrange kar paya? Tab tak till he encountered an element which has properties similar to the first element. Means ये कहना चाहते हैं कि वो तब तक उसको इंक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर में अरेंज करते गए जब तक उनको एक एलिमेंट ऐसा नहीं मिला जिसकी प्रॉपर्टी पहले और पहले वाले के जैसी हो. फॉर एग्जांपल दैट म्यूजिकल नोट सा रे गा मा पा धा नी, नी तक उन्होंने अरेंज किया, फिर वापस से सा आया, मींस द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ फर्स्ट एंड एट्थ एलिमेंट आर सिमिलर. तो उन्होंने ये बोला कि एटॉमिक मास के बेसिस पे हम एलिमेंट्स को तब तक हॉरिजॉन्टली वो अरेंज करते गए जब तक उनको कोई एक ऐसा एलिमेंट नहीं मिला जिसकी प्रॉपर्टी फर्स्ट के सिमिलर. ओके, जब वो सिमिलर मिली तो उसको वापस से उन्होंने फर्स्ट के नीचे रख दिया. देन ही स्टार्ट अगेन अरेंजिंग द एलिमेंट्स ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ इंक्रीजिंग एटॉमिक मास. ओके, सो ही प्लेस दीज एलिमेंट्स बिलो द फर्स्ट एलिमेंट एंड दस स्टार्टेड द सेकंड रो ऑफ द एलिमेंट. दिस थिंग आई हैव एक्सप्लेन यू द एलिमेंट व्हिच ही गॉट दैट दिस एलिमेंट हैव द प्रॉपर्टी सिमिलर टू द फर्स्ट वन, देन ही पुट दैट एलिमेंट in the periodic table below the first one because they both show the same property, and start keep on putting the elements and arranging the elements on the basis of the increasing atomic mass. Okay, so proceeding in this manner, he could arrange all the elements according to their properties and thus create the first periodic table. On the basis of this, he just arrange all the elements which were there on the basis of the atomic mass and the elements which have same physical and chemical properties. Okay, and he was the first person who just created the first periodic table, and this is the form. This is the periodic table. You can see this thing. We have learned about the elements, the physical and chemical properties of the elements in 10th class, right? So see, hydrogen is an element, okay? Helium is a noble gas, okay? Zero is there, noble gas, okay? Means physical property and chemical properties are of noble gases are like zero. They do not generally react with, they do not behave like metals, they do not behave like non-metals, they do not react with anything. Because metals and non-metals react with each other when they just share electrons. They accept when metals donate their electron and non-metals accept that electron. Then only the reaction will take place. But in the cases of noble gases, they have completely filled octet, so they need not to accept the electron or donate the electron. Okay, so lithium, beryllium, boron, you can see the masses keep on increasing, right? 6, 9, 10, carbon 12, nitrogen 14, oxygen 15, and fluorine is 18. After that, he found the sodium. Sodium is like which have properties similar to the lithium. So that is why he leave this column blank and go back to the first column and place this sodium below lithium. And then he start arranging the elements according to the increasing atomic masses. 24, 26, 28, 30, 32, 35. Then he found the element which have properties similar physical and chemical properties which first and this second have. Then he put this potassium below this and keep on putting all the elements like this one. So this was the first periodic table which was created by the Mendel. That is why this table was known as Mendeleev periodic table. This thing clear to you all? All these three laws are clear to you, beta? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. Ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So the main So your homework for tomorrow is that you have to read all the three laws, the Newland law, the triad law, the octet laws, and third one is the Mendeleev periodic table, and make your concepts clear. Okay, so your homework is to read the concept and find out what these scientists want to explain. What was their theory when he arranged these elements on the basis of this thing, like atomic mass or physical and chemical. Okay, so we are done with today's class. Your homework is to read these things. Okay.